In the previous class, we have derived the first equation of motion during the rotation, that is omega is equal to omega 0 plus alpha t. Today we will derive the second and third equation of motion for rotating object. So the situation is same. This is the rigid body. We have taken the lamina, the pink lamina representing the initial position and yellow lamina representing the position of the system after t is equal to t second. The whole body is rotating with angular velocity omega about y axis. So for second equation of motion, we will take up the instantaneous angular velocity, that is omega is equal to d theta by dt. So d theta is equal to omega dt. Using the first equation of motion, that is omega is equal to omega 0 plus alpha t, we can write d theta is equal to omega 0 plus alpha t dt. Now we will integrate by part. So limit will be for left side 0 to theta, in the right side 0 to t, omega 0 plus alpha t dt. In the right side by part, the first term 0 to t omega 0 dt, the second term 0 to t alpha t dt. The constant we have to take outside of the integration. So omega 0 dt limit 0 to t, and the second term alpha constant, that is the angular acceleration, limit 0 to t t dt. And when you integrate d theta, you will find theta limit 0 to t. When you integrate dt, its integrated value will be t, 0 say t, lower limit and upper limit. Similarly, when you integrate the second term of the right side, that is t dt, its integrated value will be t square by 2, limit 0 say t. So when you apply the limit in the left side, theta minus 0 is equal to omega 0 t minus 0, upper limit minus lower limit. Similarly, 1 by 2 is constant, so alpha by 2 will be constant outside of the integrated value. Upper limit when you put t square minus 0 lower limit. When you further simplify, you will get theta is equal to omega t plus 1 by 2 alpha t square. So this is the second equation of motion for rotation. It resembles with s is equal to ut plus half at square, but this equation is for rotation. Now if you come to the third equation of motion, we will start with instantaneous angular acceleration, that is alpha is equal to d omega by dt, the differentiation of angular velocity with respect to time. Purposely what we will do, we will multiply or divide this term by d theta by d theta, and we will interchange the position d theta in the numerator above the dt and similarly d omega in this side. So already we know d theta by dt, after exchanging the position, d theta by dt is angular velocity and d omega by dt. Okay? So now we have alpha is equal to omega d omega by d theta. It can be written as omega d omega is equal to alpha d theta. So very clearly you can say that in the left side, this is a variable term for angular velocity. In the right side, this is the variable term for angular displacement. So we will integrate within the limit of angular velocity and angular displacement. So omega d omega, lower limit omega 0, that is the initial angular velocity, omega in the right side, alpha d theta, 0 say theta. When you integrate omega d omega, you will find omega 0 by 2, lower limit omega 0 to omega. In the right side, alpha is constant, and when you integrate d theta, you will find theta, lower limit 0, upper limit theta. When you apply the limit, 1 by 2 is constant, upper limit, that is omega 0, lower limit omega 0 square. Similarly, in the right side, alpha constant already outside. When you apply the upper limit, theta minus 0. When you simplify further, omega square minus omega 0 square is equal to 2 alpha theta. And this is omega square is equal to omega 0 square plus 2 alpha theta. So this is the third equation of motion for rotation. It very clearly resembles with third equation of linear motion, v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So now we have the first equation of motion, second equation of motion and third equation of motion for rotating about any object about x axis.